New tonight, the president's former national security advisor, John Bolton, one of the most anticipated impeachment witnesses, had this to say today on Twitter. It probably goes without saying that our country's commitment to our national security priorities is under attack from within. America is distracted. Our enemies are not. We need to make U.S. national security a priority. Now, it's a pretty stunning statement from the former national security advisor of the United States, in part because it matches what the president's former top Russia advisor, Fiona Hill, said under oath when she said the president had a quid pro quo on Ukraine. Here she is.
When we are consumed by partisan rancor, we cannot combat these external forces as they seek to divide us against each other, degrade our institutions, and destroy the faith of the American people in our democracy.
Hill said that on camera. Bolton, though, of course, is still hiding behind Twitter and still technically doing the president's bidding because he's refusing to testify in the impeachment investigation. And to be very clear on two big points here, one, Bolton has a lot to say about what Trump did and what Trump knew and when he knew it. Bolton was in the know, and you don't need to take it from me.
Dr. Hill said that Ambassador Bolton referred to this deal as a drug deal.
Ambassador Bolton told me that I am not part of this whatever drug deal that Mulvaney and Sondland are cooking up.
I heard Ambassador Bolton express to Ambassador Taylor and National Security Council Senior Director Tim Morrison his frustration about Mr. Giuliani's influence with the president, making clear there was nothing he could do about it.
Did you tell Ambassador Bolton about this conversation as well?
I reached out to him as well and requested his availability for a secure phone call.
And what was his response when you explained to him what Ambassador Sondland had said?
Tell the lawyers.
So Bolton knows a lot, okay? And he's out there tweeting about things and teasing the American public instead of actually talking and telling everything he knows. I mean, remember the other day when he tweeted, quote, stay tuned? The reality of the situation at this point is that if John Bolton wants to actually do the right thing and protect American national security, instead of getting on a Twitter high horse, he should testify. That's the right answer for him. He doesn't work for Trump anymore. And that's the other big thing. He can stand up and speak and defy the president as nearly a dozen others have chosen to do and testify publicly. Out front now, Democratic Senator Mazie Hirono of Hawaii, a member of the Senate Judiciary Committee. And I appreciate your time today, Senator. Thank you so very much. What is your reaction to John Bolton weighing in on Twitter, talking about national security at risk and under attack from within and tweeting, stay tuned, but so far refusing to testify?
Mm-hmm. This is serious business, and Twitter doesn't do it. So, as you say, he should step forward as the other courageous testifiers have stepped forward to tell the American public and Congress the truth of what the president did.
Do you believe he will eventually testify, and will that happen in front of you in the Senate? It doesn't look like it's going to happen in the House, obviously.
One can only hope that these people will finally figure out that maybe they should really think about America and national security and not loyalty to a lying president who only cares about himself.
Now, it's not just John Bolton, obviously, who's, obeying the president. Obviously, Bolton doesn't even work for him anymore, so he really can just step up at any time.
Yes.
But he's not the only one, right? There's Mick Mulvaney and there's the Secretary of State, Mike Pompeo, also not speaking out. And here's Mike Pompeo today when he was asked about testifying. He played coy, sort of made a joke of it. Here he is.
When the time is right, all good things happen.
I don't know if you could see Senator there, his little, smile and you know, as the audience there, reporters were chuckling back at him. What do you think he means by that?
Who knows? And at this point, he's very deeply involved in all of these, what I would call the shenanigans that the president put everybody up to. And so he's not coming clean. And so what else is new with Pompeo?
So Republicans are now seized.
Now, as I said, the people who come close to the president, they enter what I call the moral dead zone. And it apparently takes a lot for them to break out of that dead zone and come clean and tell the truth.
So Republicans are seizing on comments made by Democratic Congresswoman Brenda Lawrence. You know, she has said censuring Trump in the Senate. instead of him trying to remove him from office is the right thing to do, because she doesn't think that the Senate will vote to do that, because obviously you've got majority Republicans. Here's how she explained her thinking on this show just a few moments ago, Senator.
Privately, the Republicans are saying, yes, it's not right, he's done something wrong, but it's just not impeachable. We have to put a marker down. So I'm going to do my job in the House. And when it gets to the Senate, I was putting out there that this is a way for history to reflect that this president and any president from now on, this is unacceptable.
Do you think a vote to censure the president is the way to go in the Senate, that Republicans would get on board with that when they will not vote to remove him from office?
I don't know what the Republicans will get on board with, and that's why it's very important for this impeachment process in the House to continue, and, you know, we shall see. But the expectation is that the Judiciary Committee will also engage in a process, and they will either come up with articles of impeachment or not. I suspect that they will come up with articles of impeachment. That is what we're supposed to do. That is our job under the Constitution. And it is not for us to say, well, you know, the Senate's never going to convict, so we shouldn't do it. So I obviously have a different viewpoint as to what should happen. I think we should proceed with what is the appropriate thing to do.
And therefore, have your trial on removal or not. You know, I want to play...
If the articles of impeachment come to us, yes.
Okay, so some of your colleagues, you know, I've spoken to recently, a couple of them, Democratic colleagues in the Senate, and they have been pretty down on their private versus public conversations with Republican senators. Here are two of your colleagues.
Well, what they say privately is very different from what they're doing publicly and saying publicly.
I have a number of friends in the Republican caucus in the Senate, and when I try to bring up the subject of the testimony of this week, the striking developments in the House, all of them have either changed the subject or simply said they'd really rather not talk about it.
Senator, does that reflect your conversations with Republicans, your colleagues right now as well?
Well, it certainly reflects what the Republicans are doing. And frankly, you know, what does it matter what they're saying in private if it doesn't comport with what they're saying in public? And so there's a huge chasm between what they really think and what they're saying in public. So this is why, until the Republican senators pay attention to what the president did, which was to shake down the president of another country for his own political purposes using taxpayer money as leverage, they don't want to face that. And so they just engage in all kinds of what about this or what about that? Well, what we should be focused in is on the president's actions, and they're not able to do that.